I thought I might sing some news from Africa. Journal, which is particularly aimed at African countries, and it has often good news stories of different types, people setting up businesses, good initiatives that are taking place, often really small scale stuff, but it's really impressive and you get to see what people are doing, and it's always a real treat to see what people are doing. I think that's a really good idea to do a knitting club, and the children on the video seem to really be getting into it. I'm sure they wouldn't like me calling them children. today on the radio, Matt joined me at Resonance, and we were singing songs from the old broadside ballads of the 17th century England. And for once, I would like to interrupt this broadcast of contemporary news to go back to 17th century. And actually, this is really touching this week, and I'm just going to get it sung. It is London Morning in Ashes. It's about the Great Fire. A fire, 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 I sin, not have more cause to cry. In the great chamber of the king, a city mounted high. Old London that hath stood in state above 600 years, in 6 days' space, woe and alas, is burned and drowned in tears. The 2nd of September, in the middle of the night, in Pudding Lane it did begin to blaze and burn outright, where all that gazed were so amazed at such a furious flame, they knew not how nor what to do that might expel the same. It swallowed Fish Street Hill, and straight it licked up Lombard Street. Down Cannon Street in blazing state it flew with flaming feet. Down to the Thames whose shrinking streams began to ebb away, as thinking that the power of fate had brought the latter day. With hand and feet in every street, they pack up goods and fly. Pitch, tar and oil increase the spoil, old Fish Street begins to fry. Out of the shops the goods are taken and hauled from every shell, as in a shipwreck every man doth seek to save himself. The fire so hot, a strength hath got, no water can prevail. 100 ton, were it poured on, would prove but like a pail. The crackling flames did fume and roar as billows do retire. This city, though upon the shore, doth seem a sea of fire. Up to the head of H. St. Paul's, the flame doth fluttering fly. Above 100,000 souls upon the ground do lie. Such souls and flame, this is interesting actually, sick souls and flame do flee the flame. Women whose child we know are forced to run the fire to shun, have not a day to go. And that's, yeah, about the women who are really pregnant, like just about to give birth, having to run from the fire. At Temple Church on Holborn Bridge, when Pike Corner tis stenched, the water did the fire besiege, at Aldersgate it quenched. As Cripplegate, though very late, and eke at Colesman Street, at Basing Hall the fire did fall, we all were joyed to see it. Many a French and Dutch were stopped, and also were confined. 'Tis said that they their fireballs dropped, and this plot was designed by them and those that are our foes. Yet some think nothing so, but that our God with his flaming rod for sin sends all this woe. Although the fire be fully quenched, yet if our sins remain, and that in them we are still drenched, the fire will rage again. Or what is worse, a heavier curse in famine will appear, when we shall tread with want our bread, and hunger draweth near. I think it's really interesting to sing this. As, I mean, obviously, we're all thinking about the terrible ghastly fire, Grenfell. And I'm sure lots of people lost their lives in the Fire of London, but we don't really hear about them because it wasn't documented, actually, the people who were killed.
You've got documentation about the rich people helping. They're even mentioned in a couple of verses in this song. The Duke of York, apparently he worked with a bucket in his hand to help save it, so he gets a mention. But we don't really know how many people did die in the fire in London. It says here, many French and Dutch were stopped and confined. That basically, they rounded up the French and Dutch after the fire of London and blamed it. They said it was terrorism by the French and Dutch that they'd set it off. But this ballad says that wasn't the case, that it was God and you were all evil. So I think it kind of, yeah, I'm okay with singing this ballad because, I mean, obviously it's historical, but also I don't think it, I think it's quite a solemn ballad as well. And I want to sort of, yeah, think about terrible times today and how it links up with us as humans in the past. So, I'm going to go back to contemporary news now, and back to Africa for a bit of lighter
stuff.
Good. Oh, thank you. Keeping an eye on mine. Yeah. I'm going to go back to Africa Journal.
Made of steel, neither true.
traditional crafts.
Yeah! real good role model